today when you're on the set.
Closer.
Hi.
Mr. President, the best part of the Air Force is with us today.
Hi, how are you?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you. Hello there.
So Sergeant Tim Kerwin. Good afternoon, sir.
Hello there.
Okay. Chief Select Joe Dewis. Right here for one. Okay.
Sergeant Strausz-Hope. Hello. Morning, sir. How do you do?
John, wait a minute. John, right here. Okay.
Mr. President, good to see you. Thank you.
Hello, sir.
I got it. Yes, sir.
Squeeze me as much as you can. Okay, you want to come in and turn side of the desk? Yes. Yes.
Right behind the president, can you move just a little bit this way? Okay. And move a little bit to your right, if you can, yeah. And then you, okay, good, so we can see you. Okay, right here. Henry, you got a smile, come on. One more. Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, I think it lasts a second. But it always does.
The clock is attached to the wheel.
Well, back when I was serving with the Army Air Corps, though, I had come from the horse cavalry. And it was kind of a switch. I remember one day, I don't know why, maybe just homesickness or something, I flew a desk for the Army Air Corps. Never cracked one up. But one day I wore my boots and breeches and I only did it once. The repercussions were resounding for my showing up that way. I've tried to tell people that I only took this job in order to redistribute the wealth. horse cavalry. Well, listen, I appreciate this opportunity for you to say hello and not just passing you on the way to the room up there. And I want to thank all of you for service above and beyond. I don't have any worries about, like, I'm going to have, whether I'm going to take Delta. I don't know why there shouldn't, that shouldn't be one of the perks on this when you leave, but Air Force One goes with you.
We'd have no complaints to that.
Crew likes California.
So, one of the things that makes this party easier is that I know where I'm going. Well, it's been a great experience.
We're going to be there for
a while. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you, sir.
This is Polly Ball, who is also director of the AIDS Commission. She says this one is easy.
Well, come in.
Thank you.
Why don't you take the chair over here and why don't you sit down?
Thank you.
I've been looking forward to this. Thank you. I don't know what you've been doing.
Hi. Yeah. We're delighted. This is a letter of transmittal. John Tuck has an official copy. And that has in it the gist, it's only a page and a half, it has the gist of our report. You can see it best, I think, Mr. President, if you just look at this table on page 4 here, which shows in the first column the present salaries, and the second column what the 1969 salaries would be if they were corrected for inflation since that time. The reason we picked 69 is this quadrennial commission process started that year, and Congress allowed President Johnson's recommendation that year to take effect. So that's a base for everybody. And these were the first group. Those salaries, which were then down to 40, 50,000 range, adjusted for inflation, would be over these numbers.
My goodness.
In fact,
President, Prime Minister.
Yes, Prime Minister.
Mr. President.
Well, it's good to see you.
I'm very happy to see you again.
Well, come on. Don't worry, time is limited here.
Yes, I know.
You know all these gentlemen, I think.
Professor Ken Duberstein.
General Powell, nice to see you.
Hello,
Mr. President. How have you been?
Good.
Morning, sir.
Hello.
Nice.
Good to see you.
And we'll have to sit patiently here while about 3 waves of press and pick up
this come true. Then we can talk a little business.
It's good to see you again. Everything going well?
I think everything is going all right in Turkey, and also I see everything is going well in the United States.
This is 3, isn't it? Each time?
Yes, yes, sir.
5 feet, good.
Yeah, I didn't tell you.
I've been told to jump in. How are you, old friend?
Nice to see you again, sir. How are you?
Nice to see you.
He has a present he's wearing.
I want to get in the next picture. Catch all kinds of grief out of that.
Thank you.
Mr. President, what is it that makes you think that we can trust a terrorist organization like the PLO now to abide by the resolutions of the UN and to really renounce terrorism?
Well, because the words have been spoken, the words were the words that we have been stating when necessary. But, of course, you then also, the words must be matched by performance. And if they're not, why, we're back where we started.
What do you hope to, what do you hope to come out of this dialogue, the start of the dialogue?
Well, it's all just another step in what we've been trying for 8 years to bring about peace in the Middle East.
Israel is very upset about this, to say the least. Are you saying anything to them? Do they have a reason to be somewhat upset?
Well, I don't think so in the sense that we have made it very plain that we have not retreated one inch from our position of guaranteeing the safety of Israel.
Shouldn't we also ask Israel to abide by the resolutions?
Well, I think that Israel, since Israel was part of the resolutions, I think Israel is already in the position of not wanting terrorism and so forth.
Well, that is to the point. Will she accept 242 and 338 as you're asking the Palestinians?
Yes, I think so.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Cameras this way, please. This way, please. NBC. This way.
Whatever it is you are, they look what it is.
CNN, come on.
Secure and recognize that. Withdraw from occupied territory. But the word all was not in there, and that made it really deceptive for you. Eat your heart out. I know. I didn't know we were going to sit on this couch and this would show up.
Well, next on the diet.
How's your health, sir? You look very well.
It's all right. I put some weight, and yeah. I have to lose my weight.
Are you going back to Houston, or are you?
No, I'm going to go to Lubbock. To get honorary doctorate from the Texas State University. We have a good relation with Texas, let me know.
How many of these members of the press came with you, and how many are based here?
Some of them.
This way, please. This way.
Some come with us.
Thank you. Thank you.
Join us.
Thank you.
Mike. Texas Tech. Mike. Former president of Texas Tech.
Yes,
is the president's secretary.
Yes.
Oh, you know him. You know
I know him because he had written a letter when he was president of the university.
Oh, yeah. So we have a connection
yes.
already.
Mr. Cavazos.
Cavazos, yes, sir. Yes.
And I also see Dr. DeBakey and our friends in Houston.
You are going to go to Houston?
Yes.
That's what I was wondering for a little checkup, yeah. Prime Minister had a...
I had three operations.
Three operations.
Three operations. Two in the eye, right eye, cataract, and also literal operation, was very successful. And one bypass.
Mr. President.
Excuse me.
Mr. Secretary, the mayor.
Mr. President.
Good morning, sir.
And Ambassador of God.
You are there over there.
Ambassador.
This is the
President's Day. And of course, our ambassador.
Yes, hello there. I've seen you for a long time.
Hello, Robert. How are you, sir? Nice to see you. Secretary?
See, that press is used up.
Brand new paper, so did he get one?
Used up a major portion of our time here.
A little garish.
Keep the levels high. The government's boosting of a U.S. government team to help stop the export of sensitive equipment to Pakistan was a positive step in preventing a nuclear proliferation. I just started there, but I hope we count on continual cooperation in that. On Cyprus, your support.